I've convinced most of the people in here today that the devil will lie to you. I want you to pay very close attention to what you're getting ready to see and hear. There is a real devil. The devil is real. Don't doubt it. People say, oh, you believe in that boogeyman with a pitchfork and all that? No. He's not the boogeyman. He's Satan in the Bible. He ain't nothing to mess with. Nothing to play around with. There's been Charlie sticks or Ouija boards or cutting yourself. You're opening the door for the devil and the spirit to come in you. The devil wants your soul. He was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth because there is no truth in him. The first thing I want to say, the devil lies to you about the value of your soul. Watch this testimony this morning.
The music industry, it's still very much this exploitative thing. It's still very much people signing their life away, you know, the old deal with the devil stuff. That is still going on. It's unbelievable in this day and age that is still going on.
This is in Hollywood recently. They advertised on TV that you can come and sell your soul to the devil. And people do it. It's not a joke. They want riches and power that the devil can give them. We're talking about the real devil. See him lined up?
Tell us why you're here.
I'm going to sell my soul to the devil. What else? It's Hollywood. I want to be rich. I want to have everything.
Chris.
My name is Matt Swinford.
My name is Sarah Caples.
My name is Kai. Yeah.
My name is Peter Hansen,
a.k.a. The Dark Fool.
I'm a fashion stylist, and I'm here to sell my soul to Satan.
She said, I'm married, I got everything I want, but I want more money and more things, so I'm giving the devil my soul. See, some of y'all think that's a joke, but it's true, and it's real. And the people who push that stuff a lot of times say, I don't even believe in the devil. Don't you understand that the devil wants you not to believe in him? That's his biggest trick.
What's my price?
What's your price for selling your soul? What do you want in return?
My price for selling my soul to the devil is wealth and power.
Yeah. Wealth and power.
Maybe have my own reality show.
Success in everything I've ever worked for. Absolute respect from people everywhere I go. That would be the price.
Number one thing people we interviewed asked for to change for their soul was fame. Why would the devil want your soul? Listen to their answer.
Why would the devil want my soul? I think because I have an innate ability to talk other people into following me down in a handbasket. A path to hell. He might like me because I'm a crowd gatherer.
Satan would want my soul because the way I learned it in Catholic school was Satan wants everybody's soul.
You know what the devil lies about? The devil lies about Jesus Christ. You understand today the Lord Jesus Christ is your only hope of going to heaven when you die. Jesus Christ is God's Son. Jesus Christ is not the superstar the world tries to call him. Jesus Christ is not a joke. Jesus Christ is not a play character in a movie. Jesus Christ is not some fictional figure that people joke about and use a cuss word. He's God's Son. And he died on the cross for your sin. Jesus Christ loves you more than anybody's ever loved you. Look what the devil does. The wise men coming to see Jesus in Bethlehem.
Look at us. Look at us. We get all dolled up, put on these stupid turbans. I mean, who is this kid anyway? Jesus. I mean, Latino?
Do we even know his last name is Jesus? Christ, I don't know.
You say that's just a cartoon. Yep, and you ain't got a brain in your head neither if you think like it. That's blasphemy. Blasphemy. Making fun of the Lord Jesus Christ and the birth on Calvary. Wonder who wants people not to take his birth in the cross seriously. The guy that made this cartoon, that Family Guy cartoon, is a wicked atheist. He hates God. And he hates what I'm doing here this morning. And I'm telling y'all, there's a battle for your soul right here this morning. Somebody better listen.
This one's my favorite ornament. I could
can only imagine what it must have been like for them on that very first Christmas.
Yeah, it was probably very moving and fictional.
Jesus lived.
It's probably very moving and fictional. Bible's a lie, what he just said. Can you hear? Do you hear the devil? Are you smart enough to get what I'm saying?
That's for like a week. What else do you need? It's the greatest story ever told, Meg. A story that goes back over 100 years.
Yay!
Goes back over 100 years.
It's the story of Christmas and the Immaculate Conception. You guys were born the dirty way. Now gather around, everybody, and hear the awe-inspiring tale that's caused millions and millions of deaths.
He's talking about the wars that crazy religious people started. Jesus didn't do that. Jesus was the Lamb of God that held out his hands and let him beat nails in his hands for y'all. Gosh, can you feel his power here this morning? Can you feel his presence speaking to you today? He's here today. He's in this church. He's speaking to you right now. He's saying, listen to me. I love you. The devil's saying, don't listen. Let me show you another lie. The devil lies to you about hell. You listening to me? The devil lies to you about hell. Can you hear me? The devil lies to you about hell. You know what? I used to think the devil lied to me when I was in school. When I was in 8th grade, 9th, 10th grade, 11th grade, my mom taught me there was a God when I was little, and I knew there was a heaven and a hell, and somehow or another, when I think about going to hell, I thought, my goodness, if everybody else can stand it, I can too. He had me believing that. I thought all my friends are going, if they can stand hell, I can stand hell, and if they can make it, I can too. I had no idea. Hell is a place where you burn, and you never get out. Burn. You don't get used to it. It ain't something like, well, I've been here 10,000 years, so now I'm used to it. On the 10,001st year, it hurts just as bad as it did the first 5 minutes. Hell is an awful, awful place. And if you're not saved, and you don't know you're saved, the devil's lied to you. Oh, this must be some kind of cartoon. This must be some kind of joke. But it's not, friend. It's reality. Brother, they're weeping. The Bible said the rich man begged for a drop of water on his tongue. They're screaming. It's fire down there. Fire down there. You don't want to go. You don't want to go. I'm telling you, if you're not saved here today, it don't matter what you have to quit. It don't matter what you have to do. Get rid of it. Come to Jesus Christ. Repent and honor God and get saved today. Last thing I want to say this morning is the devil lies to you about how much time you have left. You're sitting there and you think, you know what? What he's saying is right. But I ain't going to do nothing about it today. I've got some living I want to do. I've got some things I'm not going to do it today. He lies to you about how much time you've got left. Let me ask you a question. Has the devil lied to you? Has the devil lied to you?
Listen, the devil knows throughout history. Isn't it true? It's like, as long as we're not aware he's there, we think we're going through different things. And there is something about the Church of God, when she sets her eyes on the devil and recognizes he's there, there's something that just emboldens the Church of Christ. They rise up. And they withstand him. He knows that. He knows when the Church of God recognizes his presence, we typically become prayerful. We typically become bold and even fierce in our stand against him. Brethren, this he does not want. The devil is all too aware that when the Church of God arises and is awake and watching and praying, she goes to God Almighty to fetch power against him. He knows that.